Hey everyone, I'm Steph from Design Sprint LTD. Today I wanted to make a video about a tool that just came out that is called FigJam. So it's the guys of Figma who created kind of a virtual whiteboard. So it's a tool that is going to be a direct competitor of tools like Mural or Miro. And it's kind of my job to work with these kind of tools because we run Design Sprint, like 5 days workshop, all online right now because of the pandemic. So I've been really like nerding out these kind of tools, and I didn't try FigJam yet at all. I didn't even open it. I have no idea what it is. So I thought it would be fun just to record a video about me discovering FigJam because I know very well the competitors. So probably it's going to be interesting just to see the difference between between these tools. So let's get started. I'm going to check FigJam. Okay, so it's not what I was looking for. All right, FigJam, maybe in one word. That's a good start. Okay. So FigJam beta, an online whiteboard for teams to ideate and brainstorm together. Yeah, great idea. Okay, so far looks like a lot like Miro or Mural, to be honest. Kind of the same colors like Miro. I like the little dots behind. That's kind of great. It's kind of cool, kind of neat. It looks very simple. You see, so the name of the people, you see their pointers. So, okay, you can do shapes. So, okay, diagrams, I'm not very impressed with that. At least in... Oh, this is cool. Okay, the reactions are cool. So it looks you can have local reactions. So what I was saying is that, you know, these tools for diagrams, I think they're kind of missing the point. It's not, we don't use that for diagram. We use that more for creativity, at least in Design Sprint. So connected to your design. Yeah, this is cool. So FigJam and Figma live side by side. So that makes a lot of sense. So Figma, basically, it's a tool for prototyping. And that's basically the creation process, I guess, the creative process. And then you naturally move towards Figma. It's kind of cool, all work and play, no play. Okay, I don't know, I didn't get. Put a bit of music. Okay, that's a long landing page, research and mood board. Okay, they have templates. So yeah, we're gonna make the Design Sprint template for FigJam as well. Okay, well, I have to say so far, I'm not very impressed by what I see. Looks very much like Miro, I would say. So yeah, let's try FigJam for free. So I'm opening the tool, right? Okay, I like it. I like it because, wait, I'm gonna hide myself. I like it because it's so clean. I can imagine that for someone who discovers the tool for the first time, it's not overwhelming. You don't have millions of things. You know, Mural, they have everything in the sidebar. Miro, they have, you know, things like up, down, on the side. In here, it looks very, very straightforward. So what can I do? I can add stickies. Ooh, that's big. I was thinking the stickies would be a bit smaller. So I can... Ah, okay, you click once. You don't double click, you click once. Hello world. Kind of cool. I can change. Ah, okay, that's smart. It's not the font size, it's just heading, subheading. Yeah, that's clean. I like that because, you know, they're not trying to make it look, you know, fancy. You can't really choose your typography, whatever. Or maybe here. No. It's just a nice, neat typography that works well anyway. I like that. Okay, you can link. Oh, this is cool. Okay, you can add hyperlinks in the stickies. So I really like that. Change the color. Yeah, makes sense. Ooh, it's a horrible blue. Put in bold. Okay, I like it. What's that? Show, hide, author. Ah. Okay, that's interesting. But is it something you do per sticky or do you do it for all your stickies? Let's try. So I have three. Yeah, okay. Kind of takes time, I guess. But okay, I can see, I find it slightly annoying because if you forget to do it and for some reasons you want to anonymize and you need to do it manually, Well, I guess maybe if I select several. Yeah, okay, that's cool. You select and can remove them. Okay. I'm gonna try to add a lot of text. So Mural and Miro, they have different way of dealing with that. Okay, that's a different way as well. So in wait, which one is it? In Miro, it would disappear, I think. In Mural, it will make the text smaller, and it makes the sticky bigger. I mean, why not? Why not? It's a bit strange, because for real, in the real world, your stickies don't get bigger. I think they're missing the point in here, because the point of writing on stickies is to have, you know, to force the participant to kind of condense the information. So if you give them the ability to have, you know, an expanding sticky, you might have some participants who are not to the point enough and could make it shorter. So I don't really like that. What is that plus, by the way? A plus? Ah, okay, it's to add a new sticky. Okay, that's totally new. And you just copy paste, so you press Alt and you copy paste. So yeah, that's very simple. Do you have horizontal stickies? I don't think so. So this is annoying, because at least in design sprints, I really like horizontal stickies. I think I can put like the right amount of information. It looks more natural. And I don't know, it just looks less cluttered in general. So I really like the horizontal ones. So, but maybe it's here. No, so it's just square. Okay, this I don't like. See, I'm being very, very blunt, you know, when I discover a new tool. Things I like, things I don't like. What else can I do? I can add text, I guess. Okay, well, nothing special. Okay, can I make it bigger? Okay, I kind of like it, because there are a few sizes, not too many, but in the end, it's what you need. You don't need millions of more options. Okay, there is. Okay, these tools, I never use them for real, because first, I have a mouse, I don't have a super nice stylus, and at least it's not a tool that I will be using during a workshop. Like, we never draw really on the tool, but okay, it's good that it's here. Okay, there is an arrow to pick things. Fine, and there is the hand, I guess it's to move around. So this is pretty clear and clean. I figured out basically that the way to move is very simple. You press space bar, you get the hand, you press on control, you have the mouse wheel. So this is closer to a tool like Envision Freehand than Mural or Miro, because you don't really have the scroll. Like on Mural or Miro, you have a navigation mode, basically, and you don't have that control with the scroll wheel. I don't know why, but it feels pretty natural to me. So stamp, I have no idea what this is. Library, I'm intrigued. Place images, okay. Well, images, I guess it's okay. I'm gonna try with that one just to see if it works. Okay, I have a nice preview of the image. Ooh, okay, that's big. Okay, so I can resize the image. I can crop it. Yeah, all of these super straightforward. It works really well, actually. I like the crop, very, very elegant. I can turn it around. What was that? Ah, okay, just validate. Okay, yeah, so this works really well, like as expected. What is the size of that canvas? Like, is it unlimited? This is really cool. There is a limit. There is a limit. It's giant, but there is a limit. Okay. I don't know if Mural or Miro, there is a limit now, or if it's totally unlimited, but here there is one. Okay, I really like these little dots. I don't know why, but it looks a bit technical. What's that? Oh, okay. Interesting. Ah, okay, just right plus one. I thought it would be like emotions somehow. Okay, well, not very cool. Well, so maybe you can use that for voting, I guess. If you want to vote on your best idea, you go here and you vote. I mean, this is very basic, because you really need to rely on the people. Like, basically on a workshop, like the design sprint, you will tell them, okay, you have 3 votes. And you really need to trust the people to actually vote 3 times. And what I love with Mural is like there is really a voting system onboarded. In here, it's like you just have to tell people take 3 stars and then they're gonna vote 3 times. So I think that's a bit basic for the kind of interactions we have, but I mean, yeah, why not? It's a good start. I'm a bit, yeah, underhand with that because, okay, it's kind of cool, like the way they are displayed, but it could be animated or, yeah, anyway, it's kind of cool. But what I notice is like, that's the stamp and here, I guess it's reactions. Then if I press, okay, that's what I was looking for. So I don't really get it, the UI, why is it the same, under the same icon you have the two, because it's two very different things, for real. You don't use them for the same thing. But okay, it's kind of cool. It would be nice to try with other people to see how, you know, fluid and interactive it looks when you see the people liking the same thing or adding reactions. Otherwise, I have to say that it looks very, very fast, very efficient. So far, I don't see a big differentiator with Miro or Muran. It's probably a bit more clean, but also there is way less functionalities. So all in all, yeah. What I'm really missing here is like a timer, for example, that would be really cool to when you run a workshop. So I have a time timer, so I can always go analog, but it's really great to have a nice timer as part of the software, just to remind everyone to stay on track. What else do we have here? Share. So, okay, this looks exactly like Mural, basically. So you can generate a link. Anyone with the link can view, can edit. Okay, this is key. That ability to invite anyone and they can edit. So let's try. I copy the link. And then I'm just opening a private tab, okay, just to check. So I'm someone new. Can I join or... Okay, this is actually cool. Ooh, this is mean. Okay, so that's a big no-no. No, Figma, like, you just don't get it. Because this is such a blocker. So, wait, can I zoom? No, I can't zoom in, but you have to imagine. What's written here is like, you have to create an account to edit and collaborate on this file. So it means people can just watch and they can't collaborate. There is absolutely no way I will force my participants to create an account to the software to be able to use it. It's something that Miro, they have understood really well, and they don't put that barrier anymore. Anyone can enter, you can put the name and they can use the file. And here, I think for me, they are losing because you can't force your participants to create an account. It creates such a friction, and probably behind there are some ideas of like making it paid, because Figma, you know, like the actual Figma, it's kind of free until two licenses, and after that they want to make you pay. So I guess it's pretty much the same business model in here. And for me, yeah, this is really, 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 yeah. And for me, this is really like a big no-no. So don't do it, Figma. It's a really, yeah, it's a bad idea. You're just gonna lose because of that. Okay, I'm frustrated. So no, you can't really share easily your boards because your participants need to log in and register, which is not cool. I can see the other person, so it's me also, but I can see who is here. That's great. What is that little bug icon? Okay, report a bug. Okay. Yeah, it's nice. Comments. So change image. Comment. It looks exactly like the comment tool from InVision Freehand, so even the same UI. So absolutely nothing new here. What are these stars? Collaborate. Ah. Okay, that's strange. So basically, I guess they made some tests to have these collaboration tools under stamp, and it was a bit too hidden, and to make them more visible, they added them here as well. I don't think it's really great to have them here, honestly. But anyway, you should find the right place for that. And for me, it should be really part of the interface, maybe here or maybe here, living in the corner. Wait, I'm just hiding myself. It could be here, you know, like floating around. I don't think you need to hide them in here. And what that is strange. Say something. Hello. Follow me, guys. This is fun. I can see something, you know, like we can do something very interactive with that, or as icebreakers or whatever, make some jokes. I really like that feature. So it's a bit hidden, cursor chat. But actually, that's the best feature I've seen so far. So yeah. Okay, and then here I recognize the icon of components. Ah no, the library. So in Figma, you have the components and it's this icon. So, okay. Okay, so that looks very, very loosey. Basically, I have a list of kind of like clip arts. I think it's the best wording for that. It's clip arts. They are really ugly. I don't see really how and when I could use these. Like my awesome workshop. workshop. Sorry, but it's bad. Okay, so we have no interest in here. It's weird because it's like the most valuable feature, you know, on Figma is these components, because you can have like this kind of symbols where you can replicate the content very easily, and you know, you just modify once, it modifies everywhere. So I see the possibilities are crazy, but here it's not used the same way. So it's weird to use the same icon for something different. Okay, so that's monsters. Okay, what is that? Okay, so it's like libraries by people, and I could look. Okay, so I can look in other libraries. So if I'm looking for a dolphin, I'm always looking for dolphins, I don't know why. Okay, so I assume you can have a component library linked. Okay, yeah, I see a project that I was working on here that is Figma, so I can actually create a natural link with a Figma file. So yeah. Maybe, you know, if you have a whole design system and you work with some specific files and you want to easily copy paste them and have them, maybe it's interesting. But I don't know, I don't see a game changer, at least for me. It's not something I would use. So yeah, a bit disappointed by the component feature. I see. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Okay, so here, view files, texts, arrange, object, views. Okay. Beta. Good. So I think that was it for that very first discovery of FigJam. I mean, interesting, really not a game changer so far. I think Mural or Miro, you have good days ahead. But yeah, definitely a good start. And yeah, I'm still waiting for new improvement or new functionalities. At least as it is not really a tool I could use. And for me, the major pain point is really about inviting the people that they have to create an account. Please remove that Figma. And yeah, other than that, it's a great tool. You should consider adding voting. It seems very important for workshops. And yeah, and just don't block any access to the tool. I hope it was useful and fun to see me discover that tool at the actual rhythm. And yeah, if you have any question or feedback, just write it in the comment. See you very soon. Cheers.